Yes, sir. We okay? Tony.
What's up, man?
How are you?
I'm good.
Great.
Out here in, are you going to leave me hanging?
Sorry.
I'm sorry.
It depends on my head.
New the hair, new okay, hairdo so is nice.
New hair is not, yeah, I know.
My guy, thank Martin. You. Yeah, we out here in Paris, man.
It's
crazy right now, having a good time. So what's going on, man?
Let's talk. A few questions for you.
Sure.
So we're traveling around and I ask you a few questions here and outside and wherever.
Okay.
Wherever we go to today.
Okay.
So my first question, we all know you by the age of 12.
Right.
What changed up to now? You're a man.
Yeah, hopefully I look a little bit older. Got a little facial hair. But no, a lot of things has changed. Most definitely my musicality and my drumming has definitely went to another level. I've learned a lot, you know, since then. Used to be, you know, the kid prodigy that had chops, you know, that could play a lot of different things. You know, through time you play with older, more seasoned musicians, you know, that actually help you put your playing in perspective, you know, as far as you know, why you shouldn't feel here, this type of feel should go here. Also with like the dynamics as well, as far as just what the music really needs, you know. I just think I've improved all the way around in regards to that. Just, you know, just being consistent with playing like with a lot of different musicians and, you know, playing different styles of music. I think I've grown. So it's been a great process for me, and I'm still learning, you know, today, but it's been good.
Yeah, we're on tour here, and you love to play with locals as well on your workshops.
Yeah, yeah, I like.
Why? That's awesome. You're the first I ever met who's making this.
Yeah, you know, I just like to let everybody know that, you know, there's musicians everywhere, of course, in the world. And you know, sometimes in order to play with a musician, you don't have to be able to play with them or have played with them for years in order to have and make good music, you know. And one of the best things that drummers, guitar players, bass players, just musicians in general should learn is to be able to listen to one another. And that comes with building your musicality, to be able to listen. For example, if you play the guitar or you play the keyboards, and like, you know, somebody said, yo, can you play some background music for this singer, or can you jam a little bit, you need some music for this event, they had a drum set and a keyboard up there, we're gonna say no because we've never played together. No, you play some chords, I follow, we listen to one another, we vibe off each other, you know. And I want to show everybody that that's possible anywhere you go at any time. So I like to get the local musicians, you know, obviously I've never seen them before, nor have I heard them play, bring them up on stage, and we just jam, man, listen to each other, really feel each other out, and see what we can come up with. But, you know, musicianship, vibe, all that's very important, and becoming a great musician.
Mm-hmm. Okay. You're playing a lot of songs when you perform here on tour. Is there a favorite song for you to perform here on tour or wherever? Just the Tony Royster signature favorite song.
No, I don't have a signature song I like to perform. I like to kind of switch it up from time to time. There is this, it's not even really a song. It's pretty much a loop. But it's very musical, and it's in 9. But it's just a great way to show.
It's a 9?
Yeah, it's a 9.
Your favorite is a 9?
Well, my favorite is not in 9. I don't have a favorite.
Ouch.
But it's in 9,
okay.
This specific track that I play. And
sure.
Yeah, it's just great because it allows you to just be open with your playing. You can let a lot of parts go and really jump in and out when you want to, and show people, you know, that you're still catching the one, you know. It's just a fun track to play too. So And also, of course, you know, I play with Jay-Z, so throwing a couple of Jay-Z tracks in there from time to time is always good. People know me for playing with them as well. So, not a favorite, but I have a few that I enjoy playing.
Is there, Jay-Z, you said Jay-Z, so is there a really funny situation in your mind, what happens with, or which happens with Jay-Z?
Any funny situation that happened with him?
Which no one knows it, just you, and you are telling it now.
A lot of people will actually, okay, well, a lot of people know it, but they don't know it. But there was a time when I first kind of started, like in the middle of playing, which I played with him for like a year or two. There was a part in the middle of the show, and I do like a little playing, I do like a little solo, whatever, and then I stop, right? But I'm supposed to count the song in for the entire band and Jay for the next song.
Mm-hmm.
But for some reason, I zoned out, I blacked out that particular day, and I hit the last note, bam, and I put the sticks down. Now, and I'm thinking, I'm getting my rag, I'm drinking some water, just making sure we're getting ready for the next song. And I'm looking at everybody, and everybody's looking at me. And I'm like, what's going on? And then Jay turns around, and he looks at me, and he says, and I said, oh my gosh, because we had just added it to the show.
Okay.
Like, so it was something kind of new.
Mm-hmm.
And I wasn't, he made a joke about it, but I definitely was supposed to count. It felt like an eternity,
mm-hmm.
but I was supposed to count the song in, and it was just hilarious. Everybody was just waiting on me, and I was drinking water and wiping my hands off with a towel and everything. But that was funny. I'm still playing with him, so I guess it didn't really bother him that much. But
I don't think so.
Yeah, but that was a funny incident.
What are your favorite three drummers?
I won't say top three. I mean, I'll name a few. Dennis Chambers being one of my favorite. Buddy Rich,
Martin,
most definitely.
Of course.
I didn't even want to play the other day when you came up and sound checked on my drums. I was thoroughly impressed.
Thank you.
Thank you so
Thank
much.
You
your
so
hair
much.
Was different, so I know.
I know. Thank you.
I know your hair is. Would your hair look like this? I know you'll kill the set now, even more.
Sure.
I'm a little nervous.
We should try it tomorrow.
I don't know. They might not want me to play anymore.
Could be.
Well, maybe we'll see. I also like Vinny Caluta, Steve Gadd, and I mean, that's just to name a few. It's just I love so many drummers for various reasons, mm-hmm. you know, so it's kind of hard for me because I play just all styles of music. You know, if I can see if I like play just rock, then maybe I can give you my top rock drummers, top three rock drummers. But I love Latin music, so I love mm-hmm. Horacio Hernandez,
mm-hmm.
you know. Funk or just straight pocket. I love Steve Jordan,
mm-hmm.
you know, and you know, Dave Reckoff, always liked him. You know, it's just so many drummers. So,
yeah.
Sorry, I can't give you a top three,
yeah.
but those are some of them.
Perfect. So, now a really good question. So, the movie which touched you deeply, Dirty Dancing, for example,
what is
your movie? Was it Dirty Dancing?
Absolutely not.
Why?
Can't be, that's yours.
No. Never. Perhaps Chris.
No, maybe. Movie that touched me deeply. There's a movie, John Q. You ever seen this movie?
What?
Yeah. Do you know about this movie?
No.
It's Denzel Washington is okay. in the movie, and basically, to make a long story short, his son had a heart issue,
okay.
and if he didn't get another heart, his son was going to die. So nobody wanted to do the procedure because it was too dangerous.
Mm-hmm.
So he kidnapped a whole bunch of people and kidnapped the doctors and everything and went into a hospital, locked themselves in there, and then he had a gun and he tried to force the doctor to take his heart to give to his son.
Whoa.
So he can live. Yes, it's crazy. Like he was gonna do anything for his son to live, you know? So that was a very touching movie. Yeah, for me.
Whew.
Yeah.
That's a good one. Good
yeah.
story.
It's crazy. It's crazy. You should watch it sometime. Get some tissue. Okay?
Okay. Okay.
And some chocolate. You're gonna need something to make you happy, hopefully.
Oh yeah, I think so. Daily routine of Mr. Tony Royster Jr.
Man, that changes every day at whatever time that is, depending on what I do the night before.
Okay. Sure.
But I get up. I usually, when I'm at home, I usually like to I skip breakfast. I need to start eating breakfast more. But I've been doing that lately, eating some breakfast. Then I like to go to the gym. I love going to the gym. If not, going to play basketball, that's for my cardio.
Okay.
You know, I hate running on a treadmill, so I try to do other activities that allow me to run just as much and be active, just active. Eat, of course, make some music, produce. You know, okay. I'm in, you know, doing a lot of production lately, so at least make a little bit of music, practice on like my practice pads. I don't have a drum set in my house right now. I usually go to have different rooms and I go and practice. But that's what I do. Yeah, practice a little bit and then watch some TV, maybe a movie, depends, and then plan for the night. I like to bowl.
Okay, really?
I love to bowl. I like to do karaoke. Michael Jack, what up?
Perfect.
Yeah.
Can you do the Whitney Houston as well? You already did it with my name.
I did.
Come on, one more time.
Can't really do it.
Really?
Yeah, we need to pay me for that. But listen, and then yeah, the night is just is pretty much whatever. Just have a good time with my friends, you know?
Okay.
And they can prepare for the next day. That's it.
Perfect. How long do you working on your stuff per day?
Man, that also varies. I mean, I'm always on the road, so usually that's my practice when I'm on the road. And then
not,
when I,
you're not practicing
at home?
At home, especially things.
Not really. I mean, I have a practice pad drum set that I have, and this just to basically keep my hands sharp. You know, of course, rudiments and you know, things of that nature. Just to keep myself, you know, relevant.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
To keep just to stay fresh. You know. And then I just apply it to the set once I get on one. So,
okay.
But yeah, maybe like an hour or until I start sweating.
An hour.
Maybe like an hour and some change, maybe. Yeah.
Okay.
What, that's not a lot?
Wow. Just an hour?
I have to practice like 3 hours?
Yeah.
Damn. I don't know if I can last that long. Without doing something, going to get some food or something.
Okay.
I might try it. I'll let you know.
Oh, please.
What happens? Okay.
Please. Who's your favorite artist you ever worked for?
I would have to say Jay-Z, and then I would have to say, rather than Jay-Z, I would have to say like Joss Stone.
Okay.
Jay-Z, just because of him as a person, everything that he's accomplished, is definitely like a major motivation for me, you know, very inspiring, everything that he's done. And Joss Stone, just her presence on stage,
okay.
You know, and her love for the music, her passion, you know, that's like music, you know what I'm saying? She really, really appreciates the musicians, you know, that she has on stage.
Okay.
And yeah, we have a fantastic time. So I'll have to say those two artists.
Okay.
Great. Oh, Justin Timberlake too.
Ouch.
Yeah. Oh, three. Okay. Dang, that's crazy.
You worked for Justin Timberlake?
Yeah, I've played with him several times. Yeah. Right. Yeah. Yeah, we did the whole Legends of the Summer tour with Jay-Z and Justin Timberlake. It was a full tour.
Great.
Which was a lot of fun. Me and my friend Brian Fraser Moore.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
We played drums together. So he was playing for Justin, I was playing for Jay, but we basically played for both artists together because they intertwined songs, you know. So it was great. We had a lot of fun.
Great
times.
Your favorite groove now? Hit it. Was it a 9?
I don't know what that was at.
Great. Thank you for now.
Thank you, man.
Thank you.
Peace. It's okay.